seeing at the water's edge.
Yeah, kind of knows I don't do walking.
Well, would you look at what the tide washed in?
For one night
and one night only,
Donna and the Dynamos!
So how's the mother of the bride?
Much better for seeing the two of you. God, Tanya, 8 friggin' years.
I know, honey, it's just been one jet-setting millionaire. I'll hear next.
I know, and I've been chained to this place. The constant battles with the bank manager.
I pity the poor bank manager.
Auntie Rosie!
Sophie, Sheridan, you get more gorgeous every time I see you. Don't I get a big fat hug? I've come all the way here for your wedding.
I bet you don't remember me.
All that plastic surgery?
Of course I do, Auntie Tanya.
When you look at my baby, her whole life ahead of her. Mom, I'm getting married, not doing a convent.
I know. Well, in my day, you just didn't get married at 20.
Donna, in our day, we didn't get married, period.
A white wedding, can you believe this? I don't know where she gets it from.
Don't blame me, Donna. It wasn't my idea.
Girls, meet the leading man at tomorrow's shindig. Skye, this is Tanya and Rosie, my one-time backup band and all-time best pals.
Backup band, my ass.
Hello.
Hi. Heard lots about you two.
I'll bet, I hope.
Hey. How's my friend Kisvan's mom?
Don't bother, he doesn't speak Swedish. Hi, my name's Eddie. Bonjour, madame.
Enchanté.
Bon appétit.
Hi, they call me Pepper.
Why? Because you're so hot.
No, because he gets up in the nose.
Tanya, meet Pepper and Eddie, my bar staff, waiters, boatman, and general help. Only generally, they're no help at all. Don't you two have any work to do?
Honey, Taverna looks fabulous.
You've got Skye to thank for that.
Why? What have you been up to?
You haven't been here that long, have you?
No, I took a break from stocks and bonds and never went back.
Why?
I had enough. I've been dealing in the world, but I've never actually seen it.
Well, you should see what he's done to my world. He's got me online, email, wired up, and knuckled down.
You have to move with the times, Donna. No more drachmas under the mattress.
You just invent me a machine that'll make the beds.
If they did, you'd be going along behind them, making them again. I know you, Mom.
Are you kidding? I'll be more than ready to put my feet up when my boat comes in.
Speaking of boats, I'd sink that old wreck you've got moored by the jetty.
Sink it?
Well, it's a bit of an eyesore.
That eyesore is going to be my floating casino.
What?
Skye and Eddie are transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Sailing around the islands, gambling under the stars.
Gambling millionaires. Maybe a few of your ex-husbands aboard, Tanya?
I don't think so, honey. I spent their millions.
Well, girls, this is my jackpot. I need a break. I need a vacation. I've been running this hotel for 15 years, and I've never had a day off. I work all night, I work all day to pay the bills I have to pay.
Ain't it sad?
And still there never seems to be a single penny left for me.
That's too bad. Money, money, always sunny in a rich man's world.
pounds of kale on that pole.
That was nothing. Just try to kayak into the local swamps.
Yes, the wretched book of bloke and a boat in Botswana.
Thanks, Harry. I heard those little copies somewhere.
Probably goes out of fashion. There's fresh out of daily rigor for the London rush hour.
Hey, you two want to hear something interesting? See this taverna?
I'm rather impressed. I remember an old hut here. I was training bedding down with some goats.
Give me goats for camels. There was this one time in the Kalahari, the sun was beating down.
Sorry to interrupt, Indiana, but the point is, this is my taverna. I built it. Well, I designed it. I drew up the plans, what, 21 years ago? I can't believe she's gone and built the damn thing.
Who?
Oh, Donna.
Who else?
This is something I scribbled on the back of a menu. I had no idea.
I know it's yours.
Buildings are like babies. You always know your own.
I wouldn't know about babies. I've been living out of a backpack my whole life.
The happy wonder, eh? Do you think your final's going to inspire some pros?
I hope so. When I got the invitation for the wedding, I sold my editor a piece on childhood haunts revisited.
Were you born here?
I was born in the U.S., but my mom was Greek. No, the only time I came to Greece was when I was visiting my great aunt on the mainland. And that was, what, 21 years ago?
So now you've read about Seventh Taverna and the tour of the flock.
No, I think this place should remain the secret idol of all is remembered.
Well, sure, but if you lived here, maybe the idol could be the buttload of tourists bringing in big bucks.
At least they have some staff, then. Where's everybody?
Good afternoon. Can I help you?
Hi. I'm Bill Austin. You're a roommate?
Bill Austin.
Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry. So you must be...
Sam Carmichael. You're expecting us?
Yes. I'll go get the keys.
Charming. But I hope I get a chance to get my tongue around a little Greek. I haven't spoken for 21 years.
21 years? You know, this is beginning to feel like a setup. Bill, here's a story for it. Three men, strangers, are invited to a place they haven't been in 21 years by a woman they haven't seen in 21 years. Why are they here?
Huh. That's not bad. Okay, Harry, spill. What sort do you wear from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? Alright, well, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories. The Bloody Nora.
Is that a quote?
No, I know this guitar. HB, the headbanger. That's what they used to call me in those old days. And DS, Donna Sheridan. I bought this guitar for her. 10 quid and my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. So now who says I'm an adventurous little stick in the mud?
Who?
My other half. A fast car, a big house, and a season ticket to the Chelsea Football Club isn't enough for some people, is it? And they want a great white hunter too. This happening is spontaneity. That's why I'm here. Donna knew my well side. I was an exchange student in Paris when we met. And I just followed her to Greece, spontaneously. We used to sing this one.
Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What will life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
You're Donna's daughter.
Yes.
Wow.
My body looks familiar. Sophia?
It's just Sophie.
No, Sophia's the Greek. I have her name Sophia.
I'm named after Sophia.
Where's Donna? I want to see her. Thank her for the invitation.
Yes, it's really kind of her to remember us.
Oh no, you can't. Your secret, I invited you. Mom doesn't know.
But what?
Oh, Mom's always talking about our friends from the old days, and I thought she'd be thrilled if I invited you all. But she's got herself in such a state about this wedding. Mentioned unexpected guests, and she'll hyperventilate.
Hold on. Sophie, are you trying to tell me that Donna didn't invite me?
No, so pretend you're here for a holiday. She'll get a lovely surprise if she sees you all at my wedding, and then we can let her on the secret.
But, Sophie.
Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk.
You're making a mistake.
She says I began to sing long before I could talk. And I often wonder, how did it all start? Who found out that nothing can capture a heart like a melody can? Well, whoever it was, I'm a fan.
So I say thank you for the music,
the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing.
Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me.
Sophie, I don't mean to spoil your lovely surprise, but the last time I was here, Donna said she never wanted to see me again, so I'm still banned.
But that was years ago. I want you here.
Why?
Because it's my wedding and I want us to all be friends.
You're a little minx, you know? Worse than your mother. I'm glad you haven't met my boys.
Your boys? You have sons?
Yeah, I've got two. God, I'd love to bring them here sometime.
Like you used to bring my mother?
Over you.
to show again. My, my, just how much I missed ya.
Yes, I've been broken hearted, blue since the day we parted. Why did I ever let you go?
Mamma mia, now I really know. My, I should not have let you go.
I'm dreaming, aren't I? You aren't really here.
Would you like me to pinch you?
You keep your hands to yourself.
You changed your tune.
What the hell are you doing here, Sam? What are any of you doing here? I'm sorry, I'm just amazed to see you.
Well, I'm doing a piece for a magazine. Here for a holiday.
I thought I'd just drop in and say hi.
This is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because one of the local girls is getting married tomorrow, and I just don't have the staff to cope with you. It would be so much more comfortable on the mainland.
Oh, not at all. Bill sees the suffering for his art, and, Harry Headbanger here, so last word is spontaneous.
What about you?
I came to see the island. You know what it meant to me.
Well, I'd love to stop and chew over all the times, but I have to go and clean out my purse.
Hey, can I wonder her?
I was expecting a fun little housewife.
No, she's still Donna.
Just one looking, I can hear a bell ring.
So quiet. Looking out for a place to go. Where to play the rap music.
Oh,
hello. Well, the guys haven't told me yet, but there are lap dancers at the Orpheus, mud wrestling at Medusa's, and Pepper has brought his handcuffs.
Don't go.
And what? Miss out on my last night of freedom?
No, I don't mean don't go. I mean, is that really how you see it?
Yeah. No. I see it more as the last night before the biggest adventure of my life. Come here.
You know who I said I wanted to find my dad?
Oh, Sophie, we've been through this 1,000 times. You don't need your dad. I'm here.
Yes. Oh, Skye. Whatever happens, you'll never leave me, will you?
Are you crazy? You've turned my whole world upside down. I wasn't jealous before we met. Now every man that I see is a potential threat. And I'm possessive, it isn't nice. You've heard me say that smoking was my only vice. But now it isn't true. Now everything is new. And all I've learned has overturned the king of you.
And all I've learned has overturned. What can I do?
and it's gonna be so different when I'm on the stage tonight. Tonight the super trooper lights are gonna find me shining like the sun, smiling, having fun, feeling like a number one. Tonight the super trooper beams are gonna blind me, but I won't feel super like I always do, 'cause somewhere in the crowd there's you.
Myself in a thousand paternity.
It's never too late.
I don't think my other half would agree.
Oh.
You don't want children?
No, no, it's not that. It's, well, I have liked a daughter. I spoil her to bits.
Lucky thing.
Is it out here?
I don't know.
What?
I don't know who my father is.
Can I be nosy? I'm a writer, so is the territory.
Go on.
Is there a man out there? Someone to hear my prayer?
How did Mom get this place? When I was singing at a nightclub on the mainland.
She was left with some money and a will. We lived with an older lady when I was younger. Mom looked after her. Her name was Sophia.
My great aunt Sophia?
I think it must be.
But I was heard money went to family. Wait a minute, how old are you?
20.
Give me a man after midnight. Won't somebody help me chase the shadows away? Give me a man after midnight. Take me through the darkness till the break of the day.
Bill!
I'm sorry, I need some air.
Why did your great aunt leave my mother that money?
I don't know.
You do. Please tell me.
What has your mother said?
She doesn't talk about the past. She doesn't understand why I need to know.
You gotta talk to her.
This has got nothing to do with her. All my life there's been this one big unanswered question. I'm done with the secrecy.
But Sophie, this hasn't been my secret.
I've seen you twice. In a short time, only a day since we started. It seems to me, for every time, I'm getting more open-hearted. Your smile and the sound of your voice, and the way you see through me. Got a feeling you give me no choice, and it means a lot to me.
Sister.
No. Will you give me away tomorrow?
Give you away?
I feel like a more proper bride when I walk down the aisle with my father.
You've got to talk to your mother.
No, let's keep this our secret till the wedding.
She'll go crazy.
She'll be relieved. She'll see we're together and she'll see we're happy.
All right. I'll do it.
Sophie, come on. Let's dance.
Yeah.
People everywhere, the sense of expectation hanging in the air. Giving out a spark, across the room your eyes are glowing in the dark. And here we go again, and oh, it's dark, you know the end. Masters of the sea, we've done it all before, and now we're back to get some more. You know what I mean.
Now is all we get. Now
Listen, who's walking you down the aisle?
No one.
Wrong. I.
You.
Yeah, now don't worry about Donna. She doesn't scare me much.
Just a whim.
Well, I'm not pretending I really understand, but...
Of course you don't. You did just fine without a man, didn't you? You never did the marriage and babies thing, you just did the baby.
What the hell is going on here? Why are you coming down on me?
I'm going to do it right, Mom. I love Sky, and I want to be with him, and I don't want my children growing up not knowing who their father is, because it's crap!
That's Peggy, now we're leaving!
Donna!
Donna! It's a two!
Guys!
Oh my god!
Dude, I am preparing something for the wedding. I think you like it.
Ready?
I can't
hear anything.
Eddie, where did you get that monstrosity?
Oh, he's not so bad! No, I found this thing in the basement. It's just what we need for the wedding. Aren't they yours, Donna?
No, they're... And what sort of wedding do you think there's going to be with the state of the three of you? Sky, you're not marrying my daughter smelling like a frat house. Hit the tub. Where do you think you're going?
I'm gonna scrub the booze back.
Oh no, you're not. I want the champagne on ice and the ouzo in the punch bowl, lay up the tablecloths, the cutlery, the best glasses. You have to wash and polish them first. Eddie, get your boat out.
Why?
Because some of my guests want to dive down to the wreck to look for more pearl necklaces.
No, we tanked the one Sky found last night.
I don't care, it'll keep them busy till the wedding starts. For God's sake, just do it!
Yes, officer.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
done. What's the rush?
The small matter of a wedding.
Oh, yeah, about this wedding. You kept my bagpipes.
They scare off unwanted visitors?
You don't need bagpipes to do that.
I wouldn't. My bite is worse than my bark.
Oh, I know. I've got the scars. Wanna see them?
What do you want, Sam?
I've had an idea for an extension.
I don't want your stupid extension. What are you doing here?
You're living my dream, remember? The island, the taverna, my dream.
Well, this is my reality. Hard work and a crippling mortgage.
Would you like me to take a look at that roof? It's not gonna last through winter.
I'll fix my own damn roof.
Okay, fine. Be a martyr. I've got kids. I know it's hard for you, doing it on your own.
Don't you patronize me. I love doing it on my own. Every morning, I wake up and thank Christ I haven't got some middle-aged, menopausal man to bother me. I'm single, I'm free, and it's great.
Where are those happy days? They seem so far behind. I try to reach for you, when you have closed your mind. Whatever happened to our love, I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so good. So when you're near me, darling, can't you hear me, SOS?
And what's this Sky guy like? Is he good enough for her?
And that's none of your business either.
I'll go back to my room. To my son.
Oh, Harry, don't go.
Let's catch up tonight. So, why don't we catch up on last night?
I drew a veil over last night. Last night didn't happen.
Pepper! Chop, chop! Champagne cocktails all around!
The bar's over there, ignore yourself.
You have to do it. We're guests now.
Yeah, they just can't seem to find good help these days.
Is that all you caught?
You should have seen the one that got away.
This big.
Bill, don't exaggerate.
It was this big. Drink, Bill?
Thanks, but no thanks. Rosie's probably the works.
I have.
You know, always keep your whole new cookbook in my backpack.
You do? Well, then you'll know how to pepper my snapper.
Well, would you look at the time? We've got to go, girls. We have work to do.
Work?
On my face, sweetie. A little repair and renovation.
But you don't mess with a masterpiece.
He is so tragic.
Olive's no service.
Just ignore him, Tanya. He can't help being mature.
Yeah? Tanya? Can't ignore the chemistry between us.
Down, boy. Little boys play with fire and their fingers burn.
You're so hot, teasing me. You're so blue, but I can't take a chance on a kid like you. It's something I wouldn't do. There's that look in your eyes. I can feel in your face that your feelings are driving you wild. Ah, but boy, you're only a child. Well, I can dance with you, honey, if you think it's funny. Does your mother know that you're out? And I can chop with you, baby, burn a little maybe. Does your mother know that you're out?
Take it easy, better slow down, boy. There's no way to go. Does your mother know?
Take it easy,
better cool it, boy. Play it nice and slow. Does your mother know?
Months.
You've got to help me.
Why wouldn't you tell me?
I knew you wouldn't like it.
I thought we told each other everything. I thought we had trust, but you went behind my back for some stranger?
No, it wasn't like that.
Is that what this big white wedding's for? A setup so you can find your dad?
No, it's not like that.
I wanted to take a boat to the mainland and get married with a couple of witnesses, but you insisted on this fantasy wedding so you can play happy families?
It's knowing who I am. I want to get married knowing who I am.
That doesn't come from knowing who your dad is, Sophie. That comes from you. How would you feel if I lied to you? I was marrying you because I loved you, and I thought that's what you wanted. But now, I just don't know.
You don't know if you love me.
I don't know if that's what you really want.
Sorry, I'm interrupting.
No. Listen. You think about it.
No, Sky, wait.
Sophie, what's going on?
Nothing, excuse me.
Oh, hold on. He's right. You have to be sure what you really want.
This has got nothing to do with you.
Sophie, I'm your dad. I can't give you away unless I know you're really happy.
Well, I've had this conversation with my mother, and she knows me a lot better than you do.
What does Donna the Dynamo know about marriage? Or divorce? Listen, I've got 21 years of good advice to cram to about 5 minutes, so hear me out. You're so young. You've got your whole life ahead of you.
Not now, Sam. Please.
But I've been there. I've done the big white wedding and the cake, and it doesn't always end up happy ever after. I still remember pleading with my wife.
Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I have to go. Knowing me, knowing you, it's the best I can do. Carefree letter, silence ever after. Walking through an empty house, tears in my eyes. This is where the story ends. This is goodbye. Knowing me, knowing you, nothing we can do, knowing me, knowing you. We just have to face it this time, we're through. Breaking up is never easy, I know, but I have to go. Knowing me, knowing you, it's the best I can do.
I thought you said you had children.
I do. They live with their mother.
Harry, what are you doing here?
I wanted to give you this.
Well, I don't need
here on this island.
Please.
Holy shit! What's this?
I thought you must have tightened your belt a bit over these years, looking after Sophie on your own. I wanted to contribute a little bit of something to the wedding.
This would cover 4 weddings and a funeral. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, but...
But do you remember last time you said that to me?
No.
The night I bought you the guitar. I can always remember thinking, those are last words that I would hear from Donna, and I always treasure them. Oh, Harry, it's a lovely gesture, bud.
You just made that up. I'm sure I said thank you nicely like a well-brought-up Catholic girl.
That's better. You know, it's the first time I've seen your laugh since I arrived.
I'm a bit stressed, Harry. What do you expect?
I've been more of the old Donna. I've been less of the well-brought-up Catholic girl.
Thank you.
hand and slipping through my fingers all the time. Do I really see what's in her mind each time I think I'm close enough? She keeps on growing, slipping through my fingers all the time.
Hop in. I'd be strong there.
I was a fool. Playing by the gods may throw the dice, their minds as cold as ice, and someone way down here loses someone dear. The winner takes it all.
The intrepid traveler, but I come home all faint about a wedding.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Marriage, children, responsibility. I'm a writer. I made my mind long ago. I walk a lone path.
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know, gonna be around. If you got no place to go for feeling down, if you're all alone with the pretty first head on, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. Thank you.
still free. Take a chance on me. If you do my very best, but ain't no lie. If you put me to the test, let me try.
Sophie might be mine, but she might be Bill's, or Harry's.
That's right, and don't you go getting all self-righteous on me. You've only got yourself to blame.
What?
If you hadn't done my mom to go home and get married to some other woman.
That's not how it happened. I was engaged. I thought it was the right thing to do, but I came right back.
What?
I told Lorraine I couldn't marry her, and I came right back to the island.
Why didn't you call me?
I was dumb enough to think you'd be sitting in your room, pining for me. Only, when I got here, you were off with some other guy. I thought it was so stupid, and I went back home. She married me to prove it.
I'm sorry I just cut in for a moment.
Oh, Harry, the check, of course.
No, step the check, it's yours. Donna, you were the first girl I loved, but you're also the last girl I loved. There are all kinds of families, aren't there? Yours is you and Sophie. Mine is me and Nigel. It's great to have a third of Sophie. I never thought I could get that much of a child.
I agree with Harry. Being a third of Sophie's dad is great.
Me too.
Typical, isn't it? You spend 20 years searching for your father, and then three show up all at once.
Well, I mean, we could find out which one of you is my father. But I don't care. I'll find something about myself. Skye, let's not get married.
What?
I know you never wanted any of this, and I've got my whole life ahead of me. Let's just get off this island and get at that world.
I love you.
Donna's going to take the wedding canceled?
Oh, I haven't a clue what's going on.
Well, let's not waste a perfectly good wedding. How about it, Sheridan? You need someone to boss around this island of yours.
Are you nuts? I'm not a bigamist.
Neither am I. I'm a 45-year-old divorced man who's loved you for 21 years, and ever since I got back on this island, I've been bursting to show you how much. Come on, Donna. It's only the rest of your life.
I can't conceal it. Don't you see? Can't you feel it?
Say I do. I do, I do, I do, I do, I do.
Let's try it. You love me.
First of all, we'd love for the pit to come out to be recognized.